Hello YouTube family, this is my makeup for today. I didn't get a chance to do this intro video until the end of the day, so I've had this makeup on all day and it's held up well. I've been in the garden, done a little bit of this and a little bit of that. And if you want to see how to do this cute summer re-makeup look, and yes, I am of course using the palette that I am panning this year, and my panning update will be coming up shortly. If I didn't already upload it before I'm showing you this video here, I meant to do an update last month, but I lost my footage, so that's why you haven't seen it. Checking my teeth here. Anytime you have a kind of a bright color, I just feel like, oh, I want to make sure. Anyway, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please, please subscribe, leave a comment, tell me what you think of this look, you know, would you have liked to have seen it with a different lipstick? I have a ton of lipsticks that I am also panning, and I'll have to get around to doing an update on my pan those lipsticks 18 and 2018. I gotta get to my update soon, but I have been panning. In any event, this is the look. It's a little bit of green and sea blue for the summer. Welcome summer, welcome new subscribers, and welcome to everybody who's watching this video. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay, so this is where we are. We're still panning. We're going pretty good, I think. We're at the halfway point, or almost the halfway point. And I think we're more than halfway finished with the palette. So now let's do our weekly makeover. I'm using this cool tone brown called Chessboard right here as my transition shade. It's a lovely, deep, smoky transition color. Ew. I adore. Look at that. Difference between those two eyes. Now we'll do the other one, of course. Smoky, smoky. It's always a wonderful thing to have colors that go darker, so you have something for the summer months when you're bronzed and something for the winter months. It's always nice. Okay, so there we go with that. And I'm just gonna brown this out with this Too Faced bronzer color. This is their light shade of bronzer. It is a golden frost bronzer. Just a good trend. This is a good, just all over color for me. It's pretty close to my skin tone. Got our color pretty even there. All right, nice. Now, let's move into our fun stuff. I'm going to keep on using Paradox because I have it in my new distortion palette, so I feel like I can finish it in this palette. I'm going to sponge from the inner crease out. This fluffy Wet n Wild brush that you pick up at the dollar store just to put that color all over, because we want a nice summery golden look. That's what we're going for. And my skin color orange is a pretty summery look. Yeah, with that gold all over, all over. And then we're gonna go underneath the eye as well.
gives that eye that soft, pretty, comforting expression. Like I care, which I do. I'm gonna use Chronosphere, which is another cool tone brown, but this is a very dark, cool tone brown that flashes gray, silver. Ooh, so pretty. And we're going to take that brown into this area right here. Just right there. Nowhere else. Just Chronosphere on that outer fourth of the eye. Because when we blend it, it'll come in more. So we don't want to overdo it before we blend it. Because then it'll be all kind of places that we didn't intend to have it. Yeah. You know how that goes. And I'm just layering this up until it gets dark on me, knowing that you see how it flashes, that silver flash. So pretty. So pretty. And then, I wasn't going to do this, but I decided I want to do a halo eye with this. So I'm going to take this, not quite at the very end, and just kind of darken that inner color there too. So sexy. Now we're going to go in and do our crease work. Pleasures, this is a Sears brand, and I'm going to use that to do my crease work. Since I want to have some fun for summer, I'm going to do my crease work in this very unusual color right here. It's like a sea green, sea blue color. Very, very deep color. Very warm and muddy. Ooh, I love this color. Called Bandersnatch. For my eyes, I'm going to go just a little bit above the crease there. Just a little bit. Oh, that's pretty. I love it. Open that eyes up. And take it across on the inside. Ever so softly. Then I'm going to take the color that has the golden in it. And blend it out. In the inside. And the color that has the bronze color in it. And blend it out on the outside. That green just contrasts my skin. It looks so pretty. Take a little bit more. I'm not trying to make this extremely dark. I don't really usually go for a very dark look. Now do a little blending there, just a little bit. You know, I like to see my colors. And I will go back and beat that little tip. Rounding out my almond-shaped eyes, I'm going to take this Royal Flush and put it in the middle of this color. Just a dot. Because this is beautiful to me, but I want to make my eyes as round as possible. So just right there, a little dot. I need more color though. Yeah, there we go. A little bit lighter. Go, 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 girl, go. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about right there. I'm having to layer this up. Ew, yes. And then let me just blend her out into my golden color. Oh, that's pretty. Okay, so now I'm using the golden color to just blend into that because the golden color is more dimensional to me. Fun. But I wanted those eyes to pull very, very round. Okay, I see we're at the top there. I need to blend those in there just a little bit. I'm happy with that. Yeah. Cute. I love it. Okay, so I will put, I need to clean this eye look up, obviously. And I will put on liner and mascara. Okay, so I'm gonna go for it. I want a thick liner. This eye look is somewhat dramatic and I think it can pull off a very, very thick liner. So when you do a thick liner, the issue is right along the lash line. For me, I have a very fat lash line, and sometimes the lash line can show as skin tone or eyeshadow color underneath. Like I have not even, you can see my fat lash line is still not even completely covered, but that's my starting point. Okay. Now we'll go through and do this one on the other side. I'm going all the way in the inside. This is preparation for a thick liner. Now, what I'm doing now is I'm looking at my eye and saying, where do I want my liner? I want it there. I want that wing to go up there. And now I'm just going to go across from that wing and fill in some more. See that? And then just take that little tip there and kind of get all in one. Now if you mess up like I did and go a little lower, no biggie, you just go a little lower. And then I need to keep my eye down so that it can dry. Makeup Forever. You see it's got my eye makeup on it. I close my eye and just make sure I can feel it on the up and the bottom. See the difference? So this is my finished look. I am on my way out and about, and I hope to see you again soon. Thanks for watching this video. Jesus loves you, and I love you with all the Jesus in me.